It's Wednesday morning. It's 6:30 in the AM and I've walked down to the allotment. I'm at the far end, my allotment's at the other end. I'll turn around in a second. It's not a huge allotment, but you can see, look, it's frost. It's frost, and a lot of people have been putting out their runner beans and stuff. So look, there's my allotment at the end, but my allotment's in sunshine. Yay! But this end, look at the frost. Look at the frost. Now, will this be the last frost of the year? And the weather forecast says it's warming up, and then in long forecasting, it's going to be extremely wet for the next weekend. Well, not extremely wet, but heavy showers. So we'll see. Heavy showers generally doesn't mean cold frosts, because the skies are overcast and the heat is retained. But yeah, in the shade, definitely heavy frost. So hopefully people who've got their beans out are going to be all right. It's a lot of traffic noise. It's Thursday, it's election day. Now, I'm not sure if you can pick it up, but that pond is looking very poorly. There's just like a scum over the top. And I think it's because the water level is so low and there's so much silt and algae building up in it now that it's not doing very well. Now, we are forecast some showers, heavy showers, quite continuously for several days, so hopefully that will help us and a blackbird that will help us get the pond clean again. Otherwise I don't really know what to do. I can't put more water in it myself. Have a quick video of what I've been up to. Somebody gave me some more grass just by the green Dalek there. If you're wondering what this old piece is in the middle, you can just see through. I've tied up two pieces of the scaffolding netting together, and there are gaps in the middle. So this old piece, which I got, somebody gave me from another plot, is so old it tears instantly. So it's good for nothing, but it does actually cover up, apart from in places. I just need to readjust it. It does cover up the hole, so butterflies won't get through. Nothing's changed here. I brought down a lot more of the seedlings from outside the bungalow to harden off, but this is what I have done. So the pak choi was planted a few days ago. I've now planted three rows, which is one type and two rows of another type of kohlrabi. So there's some delicate and another unpronounceable name. A little bit of water in, but not too much, because we're going to have tons and tons of rain over the next few days. And down here are the turnips. These are the snowball turnips, which I shall be using for salads. That's most of what I've done over the last few days. The only other thing, of course, is the big thing, is that now that we have no frosts forecast and we might be out of frost season, all the beans are in. Yay! Scarlet runner beans, white ladies, and then dwarf beans, French beans, and some more dwarf beans. Yes, these will be slightly in the shade, but the sun will come up over there, and it will be all the way around there before it starts going in shade. So I'm not too fussed about it being partially in shade. I'm going to grow just to get more seed from. And I'll try them. If I prefer them to the crimsons or the white ladies, then I'll concentrate on these on the main growth. I have got some more. It's actually a plastic, which I'm not fond of using, but I have got it, so I will use it. I have got some more. It's actually strimmer cable. It's 2.4 millimeter strimmer cable, and nobody has a 2.4 millimeter strimmer that I can actually give it to. I did ask around, so what I'll do is I'll just make more connections up using this strimmer cable. It should be adequate, shouldn't break. There are some more dwarf beans over here in a gap where I obviously didn't plant any field beans. So that area there, so there was an ant's nest there, so I actually had to claw that over a few times in order to get shifty ants out of there. But that's what it's looked like at the moment. You know, everything's going well. I did tidy this up. Oh, sorry, yeah, we got these. Now, again, these are donated. These are all runner beans which have been donated. And what I've done is I've put the bottles over just to give them a chance to grow, make sure there's no frost, because there's not many of these. So I'm using these with bottle tops as slug protectors, frost protectors, bird protectors, wind protectors, anything you like, just for a few days. And then when they've hardened off a bit, I'll take them off and they can go, start climbing. Oh, noisy. F-35, Lightning IIs out of RF Marham. Right, there we go. Plans for today, only one. I've got several things to do. One is more weeding, always more weeding, weed, and so on and so forth, picking. But the big plans is to turn everything over there. That's the compost heap, leaf mould, compost heap bins. Everybody. And what I'm going to do this afternoon is turn the pony poo, because I need to go start getting more pony poo, because this area is flattened off. If I leave the pony poo too long, it piles up at the other end and I get questions going, when are you going to come and get more pony poo? And I don't want to look a gift horse in the mouth, so I'll do that today. Somebody gave me some more raspberry runners. I need to water those in. Ah, thank God you remind me. I'll go and water these in now. Somebody gave me some more there. These are autumn ones, so they'll grow and fruit on the same year. And somebody else gave me some more autumn ones, and these grow and then fruit the following year. And these ones I'll put along the fence in the gaps, so that I get a nice bush of raspberries there that people can come and help themselves to. I'm sure they're asking. Right, see you later. It's Sunday, it's early in the morning. It's only about 8 o'clock in the morning. Nobody's on the plot, sorry, on the site. It's lovely, really quiet, the birds are singing. Ducks are quacking. A couple of cars around, a couple of people walking dogs, but other than that, it's lovely. The irises on the bank are beginning to bloom. Look at that. Look. The irony is, these were given to me by another allotment holder who were given them by the person that upset me so much. There you go. Gladioli, other things coming up. This has now all been seeded with random packets of seed in little areas to try to give it some body as time goes by. And I've also got lots of other seedlings to go in to give it body and depth. Lots of herbs growing to go in here. I put in some borage. These should have lovely flowers that should attract the bees and things. I don't think that the sage and rosemary that I've popped in will take, but I'm trying to do something about that at home. They might do. There's some over there that might be taken anyway in the other thing. Everything else, let me show you what I've done. Peas and beans are planted. There's these are the ones that I was sent very kindly, thank you very much. Different types. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. I still got bolotti beans to go in. What I'll probably do is make another pyramid over on that section there. But everything else, I mean, these are doing really well. As you see, those are beginning to grow. I don't know which will need supporting up that wire or which will just be freestanding. It's all new to me. The snap peas looking good, lettuce and all the other things growing under there. What has happened, let me just show you, all the beans are in now. These are all the French beans. I know it's early, I know, but we've got a good forecast. All the French beans are in, all the dwarf beans are in, some over there, some here. They're looking okay. Runner beans are looking fine. What has happened? Now, here's this carrots and parsnips, but as you see, there is so many weeds here, you can't actually see where the if they're seeding or not. I don't know what's going to happen with these, I really don't. There's a lot of weed in there. I'm just hoping that when they come through, I can see them and hoe between them. I think the beetroot are beginning to show. See, that's a beetroot there. But I don't know. You know, the carrots look very much like grass at this stage, so it's hard to tell. So anyway, we'll see. I've still got the ones that come out the gutters. They're looking all right. I'll need thinning at some point. And of course, at some point, I'll need to put round Enviro Mash. But as you see, I put in a row of beetroot, as I said I would do, all the way around. And then around that, I've put a row of marigolds. There we go, all the way around. That should look nice. That should also cover any smells that escape from the Enviro Mash. This is borage again. It hides the smell of carrots and things. The choy sum looking okay. Pak choy that I've put in looking okay. Space for other stuff. Space for other stuff. This is the snowball turnips, and some of them look a bit weak in the centre. But I've got replacements. Now, I put them in at this size because they were getting incredibly leggy. These are more beetroot. These are the, excuse me, multicoloured beetroot. I've still got lots more beetroot to go in around various sections. I want to try this slug-free thing with beetroot. So there'll be a row of beetroot up here. There is one already across the top. There'll be one down the other side and one down this side when I finish planting the last of the brassicas. There's still some more types to go. This needs redoing. It's sunk. The top's blown off over there in the wind. So I need to get in there and do that. Now, I also need to put in a couple more rows of things. One here, one here, one here, and one there, because the last of the Brussels sprouts, the other variety, will go in there, and then this actual barrier will move right up against there. As far as the potatoes I've planted, nothing showing in this row. Some free grass. Nothing showing in that row. But if we look over at the pea section, walk this way. Do you get me fed up with me doing that all the time? If we walk over to the pea section, the potatoes that I planted here are beginning to show. There's one there and there's one at the other end, I've noticed. There he is. So they're beginning to come through, which is great. There are some potatoes in there as well. These are the shallots that I was given at the last minute. And what I'll do is, when they start to show, I'll keep earthing those up, but I'll use the straw, the poo straw from over here, to actually earth them up, the same way I have done the others. I was given loads of freebie raspberries. Those are autumn fruiting, so they'll be up and out this year. And then there were some more runners off summer fruiting, so they'll just have the stalks this year. But it's meant to be a bush. The whole idea of putting them in there is to have a bush there so people can't just keep climbing over if they want to. But it will also hide up stuff. This has got incredibly weedy. I don't think this is working well. This has had seed put down it, so I'm trying to leave it to be like a nature area, but I want to have this side as the bed for, well, apart from these strawberries, for some squashes and things. All this is going to be like squashes and overflows from other areas. Excuse me. But as far as no-dig beds go, and it's not looking too good. But we'll see. It's early days yet. Excuse me. Tickle. I did trim up some of the daffodils, stop them going to seed, so that all the energy goes back into the bulb for next year. Bulb might even split if it's doing that. One thing I have noticed is, not so much in this one, because I knew that was going to be seeded, but in the last few days, look what's happened to in here. This is just in the last few days. There's a myriad, I don't know if you can see it through that mesh, but there's a myriad of, there we go. There's a myriad of, it's focusing on the mesh, not on the ground. Seedlings all popped up. I'll show you more on another plot over here, you see. You see this plot here, this was rotivated, and now it's got millions of seedlings all over it. That isn't planted, that's just weed seeds. So I need to get under that and hoe it and keep it up to date. Other than that, that's all I'll be doing today. It's forecast for wet weather all day. So I'll just, I'll probably pop down later on and have a look around. I've got things to do in the greenhouse. I've got some separating to do. Oh no, look, radish. Woo-hoo. Are they radish? They are radish. Lots of radish. My catch crop's coming through. That's quick. That's quick. That was only done like a week or so ago. That's lovely. What's that one? Parsley. That's not coming up yet. Oh, it might be. There's a few there, yes. And then, as I say, from here onwards, I need to actually add some more. Great stuff. Really pleased. Here's one negative thing that is upsetting me, apart from the fact it needs a good weed. My shallots seem to be going to seed. I'm trying to seed all the time. I'm forever breaking off these little seed heads that are trying to grow. I don't know if it's going to have any effect, but what worries me is that the plants will still try to, well, won't grow anymore. Now look, they're just trying to go to seed, and all their energy is going into these seed heads and trying to. It's very sad. They were doing so well. I don't know if it's a change of warmer weather that's causing it. See, even when I break them off, they grow back. Just keep breaking them off. If anybody knows if that's gonna be effective, please let me know. Right, annoying. That's a very upsetting sign. Whatever that scum was on top of the pond the other day, it seems to have killed a frog. I hope that's not the only frog. I hope there's lots more in there that are healthy. If you look around, there are often little bubbles and stuff happening. So I'm hoping that there are still things alive in there, but seeing that frog there, that's upsetting. It really is. 7 a.m, Wednesday the 10th. There's a lot of traffic around this morning. I would have thought people would want to rest, wouldn't you? Go. I'm down on the plot. I haven't been sleeping well, waking up early. Still not 100%, you know, up here. And I'm a bit bristly as well. Yeah, please forgive me. Yeah,
car, van, white van. Right, so the reason I've come down today is I came down to look at the pond and, oh, slugs. Hang a sec, let me turn you around. Oh my God, look at the bristles. Right, let me turn you around. Right, let's have a look. No, I actually caught two slugs and a... No.
Oh, what's that? Yep.
Ugh. See, this is a great way to catch stuff. I keep a very clean... Oh, he's gone. Oh,
damn it. Where'd he go? Oh, well. I put it... Oh, there he is.
Right, don't look.
Swim.
Right.
Oh, there's another one.
I keep a very clean patch. Don't look.
Swim.
And another one. I keep a very clean patch. These are babies. So the slugs had babies at some point. And now they're all over the place. And the thing is, the babies wouldn't have travelled far, so they're going to be in this vicinity. Now, I keep a very clean patch. No wood lying around, no stones lying around, holding plastic down. So... Yeah, so there's not a lot of places for... Oh, I'm looking down, looking at these things, and they're sycamore. There's still sycamore buds and stuff that have dropped down. But you can see them all over here. Right, so I keep a... Oh, look!
Irises.
Again, absolutely gorgeous. I love it. Yeah, anyway. Yeah, so I keep a very clean patch, as you see. There's no stones holding anything down. Even on the netting, I push it into the ground rather than hold it down with rocks or bricks or pieces of wood. So there's not a lot of places for slugs and snails to hide, and this is critical. If you have wood down there during the evening, they'll come out and they'll do sluggish things or snaily things, and then in the morning they'll creep back and hide. So that's one reason why I've popped down these are my slug traps. And what I'll do is each day I'll come in early in the morning and pluck away the wee devils to get rid of them. Now, one good thing, the other thing that, if you remember, I used to use 2 litre water bottles filled with water as things to hold down. And that's great, because again, the slugs won't go underneath those to hide because they're too open in the daylight. So there's a good trick there to keep your area relatively slug and snail free. Just put down traps. The other thing is oranges. If you don't eat all of the orange, you know, if you leave a bit of the flesh attached to the peel, for some reason slugs go mad on it. So stick a bit of orange peel or potato maybe under the, say a brick or a tile. Like that big old broken house tile I've got there. If you stick a bit of orange down there, after you've gorged yourself on the rest of it, that...
What? What? Oh, what's that there? What's that there? Person? Cat? Dog?
That may not survive now. That's another one. What's had these away?
Oh, so upsetting. Right,
I think these are just bending out, they just need pushing back.
What was I? Oh, peas, I have peas, I've got peas. I didn't even see them growing. Peas, I've got peas. I've also got something eating the peas. Never mind.
There we go. Oh, I've got peas. Isn't that gorgeous? They're not ready yet, of course. Right, anyway, yeah. I've totally lost track of what I was saying. Oh yeah, orange peel, put it underneath there and they're attracted to it, and that'll save you on buying tins of beer and stuff. Right, let's talk ponds. As you know, a little while ago, I came down and I saw a dead frog over there, and every year, of course, this is a water drainage pit. It's not a pond per se. So every year it dries up. So, and I've just been given a load of nice things for ponds. A neighbour, a couple of doors away, gave me some lovely water irises, and there's a water reed in there, I think. And in here is a huge block of, can you see it? There it is. A huge block of, water lily. And unfortunately, they probably will die. They'll probably survive until like mid-spring, late or early summer and stuff. And then this will get so low, and which means that the pollutants and silt will get rid of all the oxygen in it, and they'll probably die. And we've already seen that there was a pollutant in here the other day, because it's killed the frogs and made it go all sludgy. And I don't know what it was. It might have been fertilizer. It could have been weed killer. Could have been anything, but this pond is very susceptible to that. So what I've decided, and I'd love your thoughts on it, and I need your help, to supplement and complement this pond per se, what if I built one here? If I moved the table from here to here, have a nice little table area here, there's plenty of room here, I could move the burner to say here, just this little patch here, maybe over here somewhere where it's not above, you know, there's nothing above it. So I could move the burner there, and then I could put a pond, because we've seen how boggy this gets, I could put a pond in this area here. And, you know, it wouldn't be that deep because obviously the tree roots and things that come across, you can see there's one there. But at least it will be something. And then I could keep this pond all the year round, put in the oxygenating plants, make it big enough to say have one or two lilies in and some of more oxygenating plants. Let me take you to my little neighbour's plot. Walk this way. Talk this way. Walk this way. Such a long walk. They're doing really well, look. So much work being put in there now. Their polytunnel did blow away and I had to retrieve it from the hedge. That hedge. The one further away on the other side of the road. That was fun. But my neighbour's got a little pond over here. It's doing so well, look at it. It's oxygenated, it's got all these oxygenating plants in. Even the ducks came and sat in it during the last few weeks. There's tons of little fleas in there. We didn't find any frog spawn, but give it time. So yeah, he's got a lovely little pond growing there. So, and if his is that small and it's doing well, then another one maybe would do just as well. So I reckon if I dig all that out during the next few months and put in a big liner, by the end of summer I could have a lovely big pond just there to complement that one. So I'm sure I'd get all the toads and other stuff coming over and using it. What are your thoughts? Please tell me in the comments below, do you think I should turn this area here into a like my own pond? I'd love to have your thoughts on it. One more thing while I'm down here. I've decided to pull out all of the beetroot. I did get a little meal out of them. Got four or five beetroot from the ones I pulled out the other day, the tall ones. But these other ones are all beginning to go the same. So at some point when I need the space, I'll pull all those out. Likewise, there's some all the spinach is beginning to go now. This warmer weather has mean it's trying to go to seed, and I don't really need any more spinach seed, but I'll pull all that out. I've got more planted here, which is doing very well, thank you, including that center line, which is perpetual spinach, so that'll be there. I'll also put some perpetual one in the polytunnel probably as well, so it's there all the year round. But yeah, I've decided to pull it out. Look, well, there's a ladybird on there now. I can see a ladybird just there. You see him centre of the screen? Fly away, fly away. Yeah, so I really need a camera. Nice fall. That'd be lovely. Right. Yeah, what shall I put into place? Well, I've got tons of stuff. Never know. More things. I do need to find somewhere to put my tree cabbage. I'm not really sure where, because it's going to have to be netted. And it's going to get quite tall, so that may not be the right area for it. Or I might put it in the centre line and then build it up with some sort of stick system. Because in the centre, obviously, that's where it's going to be the loosest. Especially at this end, where I'm not using it all. So maybe right in the centre there, I'll put a couple of tree cabbages right in the centre. A couple of tree cabbages. And then I could come for my normal evening walk around the allotments, but I thought I'd just show you that. It's like something out of Independence Day, if anybody's ever seen the film. Ominous black cloud. It's been lovely sunshine, warm today, but this is what the evenings look like. It does look as though it's raining over in that distance there. But yeah, ooh, black clouds. Hammer it down, boys. Brace for impact. It's 7:30 in the morning and I'm back on the allotment. Oh, I love it when it's warmer and I can do this. I'm wearing shorts, I'm wearing Crocs. I'm cold. But it's I'm not staying either. I've come down to do the slug bit. I did a disaster. I planted my turnips the other day and then I raked them. So I've got the spares ready and I'll replant those. I'm such a div. Right, so what we're doing today is it's going to be forecast for rain all this afternoon. Well, it's been forecasting rain practically every day and it hasn't. But what I am going to be doing is weeding. It's going to be a lot of weeding. Weeding, weeding, weeding. I've cleared some of this, ready for more stuff if we want it. I can plant the squashes straight into these banks and keep it all inside. But as you see, there's a lot of things around on this side particularly, not so much on that side. They all died by the looks of it. There was one over here and one there, but they look to have died. But bank needs tidying. Right, so and pony poo, more pony poo to be collected. Right, so the reason I came down this early, just apart from just having a look, is I'm going to go hunting. What have we got? Oh, look at you. Oh, two. Oh, right, don't look. Don't look. Don't look. Don't look. Are you looking? Don't look. Don't look, don't look, don't look. Look away. Good. There we go. Murderer. There we go. One. newts and tadpoles, they love the little baggers. Actually, I'll put it in a different place. There we go. Right, what's on this one? Oh, disappointing. Let's put you over there. All right. I bet you're eating to bits. Let's see what's on the other side. Funnily enough, the other run of beans aren't being touched. These ones over here aren't. Right. Oop, step. Reach. What have we got? Nothing. Nothing. All right. Okay, good. Still being eaten though. Survive, survive, grow, multiply. Right. That's it for now. I just came down to go back, finish my coffee. At the moment, everything is about weeding. Just getting in, packing out the little ones, making sure that the stuff that you have planted has a chance to grow. Things I germinate in the ground just don't seem to take down here. It's an awful place for germination. You can just see about, black beetroot coming through. You can't see many of the carrots coming through, so it's still a bit not easy to do. I might just get my hands and knees and just use my little hand hoe to do those. These have got to come out. I should be doing these today. Oh, I know what I was going to do. Somebody's left. We put them away for tonight. Somebody left a big... You know, I remember the potatoes that somebody left, and I grabbed a few, and other people all shared them. They left them on the share table. Somebody's left a big bag of onions. Mostly red, but a few ones. Seeds. What are they called? Onion sets. So tiny little onion sets. So when I take these out, I'm going to put some more carrots here. But when I take the beetroot out, I may just do a couple of small rows of onions. I don't expect them to get very big at this stage of the season. But, yeah, why not? Actually, I may do one row of onions down here. Or maybe two down here. Or one here and one down there. And then another, some more carrots and stuff down there. And then I can, these onions will mask the smell of the carrots. And then I can put a net around a whole lot. Birdies. Birdies everywhere. Tweet, tweet. Right, that's it. I'll go back, finish my coffee, and then come out later. Got to fix all this. Got to plant some more. I brought down the other Brussels earlier. But everything's being eaten by slugs over here. So the last of the choice sums gone to seed. But there's the other Brussels I need to get in. But I want to start getting everything in now. I'm not sure what to do with the other thingies. What I want to do, random beans, what I want to do is, the wolf this way, is I've been thinking about it. I'm going to put up some sort of structure along this bank here. Post structure. And then I'm going to do a vertical wall of melons. And I might do like a structure just here. And I have a vertical wall of squash. Just to see how that works out. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then the rest of the squash can hang over here and grow down here and here and here and stuff. Oh, I was thinking of doing my blotty beans in a pyramid just here in a teepee. All that poo should do them nice. Right, I'm out of here. Oh, I loved it. I love it. It's what's the degree-ish? It says it's 11 degrees, but I'm not cold. Shorts, Crocs, but I've got my zip-up black cardigan type jacket on, hoodie. Yeah, sorry guys, you've got to come out, you're all going to seed. I'll salvage it, it'll all go in the freezer. It'll all be stews and curries and stuff and pastas. That will all be saved, and I'll save all those as well. All the little beetroots. I've got a few in the fridge that I'm eating. But as I say, there's more perpetual spinach and two different types of spinach there. And some kale. That's why I've covered the kale, because got a weed. That'll be weeded. Got a weed. Got to come out. Still waiting for that to get bigger so I can weed it, but I might do it by hand. Got a weed. Got a weed a lot. And what I did last night, walked this way. We just walked this way, I know. What I did last night, look at it. Comfrey tea. Yeah, I fed practically everything, apart from the brassicas. I'll do those when I take all this down. I'll do them individually. But yeah, I fed absolutely everything I could with comfrey tea, even though it had been raining. Didn't do the carrots, because they don't need all those ones. Didn't do any of that, because they don't need feeding, really. They like plain stuff. They like good, wholesome, plain food. Like us country folk. Did feed the potatoes a lot. Look at them, look at them, look at them. Look at them. Yeah. Yep. All right. Might put some more earth in that one. Right. See you guys later. I've been a busy boy. I'll just show you this. This is my cat. What are you doing? Where are you going? What are you after? What are you after, Bubby? Well, you've had some food. And some dry food. You have to eat that. No, she says. Let me press that little ginger button and see what happens. No, your legs might fall off. Right. Yeah, so I just thought I'd show you this. 11 bags of blanched spinach just cooling before they go in the freezer. These will be used in, well, anything really. Stir fries, curries, stews, pasta, anything. Anything. Puff and cake. And there's the beetroot I took out. I washed it down at the plant, down at the plot, sorry. As you see, they're only tiny, but what I'll do is I'll pickle them up, slice them, pickle them up, leave them in the spicy vinegar for a little while, and then that'll make a nice little compliment. That looks so green and red on the camera. It's not that colour though, it's a bit duller. She wants food. She's not getting any. She should have been fed. I'm worried about her eating. No, you stop nudging me. Look, stop nudging me. Yep, shorts and Crocs again. Right, I'm off down the allotment. I'm going to have another look around. What I'll do is I'll show you the spaces these have come out of. And then I'll probably wind this up for that week. So let me join you again while we're down on the plot. And this is what the bed looks like. Anyway, look, choice sum is flowering. And this is, everybody will say, oh no, it's gone to flower straight away, it's seeding. Well, choice sum is also known as flowering pak choi. So don't fret, everything on the choice sum is edible. The flowers, the shoots, the leaves, everything is edible. So don't worry about it, just, you know, just pick off the flower seeds. Take them home, have them in a salad, put them in a stir fry. Enjoy them. Very, very lovely, tasty and healthy. And there's the space where the beetroot used to be. So I've still got to put in the rest of the turnips, the spare ones. I'm going to seed some more. I'm also going to seed some more. I'm going to plant a row of onions down here to mark the boundary. And then I'm going to put some more carrots and spinach in this bit here where the, carrots and parsnips in here where the spinach was. That's it. I've had a tidy up over here. I've started to bring flowers down. So here we have all of the beetroot ready to go out. I've still got a lot of beetroot to put in. Oh, tummy ache. Here we have all of the stuff that's extra. I brought some tree cabbage down. They'll be going out soon. Most of this other stuff here. Oh, no, I got the chard down. Spring onions, more chard. Most of this other stuff is just duplicates waiting to be sorted. And I've started to bring the flowers down. Oh, my God, look at how much water there is around. So there's all the flowers start to come down.
Californian poppies, normal poppies, oh, lots and lots of bits and pieces, lobelias, night scented stock. Yeah, it's all going to go in this area around here. Make little displays of them. Oh, look, the alliums are coming out. They're going to be beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I'm not sure what this weed is, but I think it flowers, so I'm leaving it in for a little while to see what happens. See if it will be like a bee attractor in between the flowers. I'm not really sure what it is. If anybody knows, please let me know in the comments below if I ought to pull it up, because I've got quite a lot of it. Everything else looking good. Somebody gave me some plants. These two little... Oh, you can't see because of the reflection. Come over here. That pile and that pile are water lilies. They're weighted down with a stone. So you've seen some tendrils, but the majority of it is weighted down with a stone. And then over there, you see there's three there and a couple over here. The reeds, the irises, water irises, that somebody also gave me. So I'm hoping that they'll take and help oxygenate the water. I don't hold much hope for it, but there you go. Right, that's it for this week. Too much traffic. Hang on. Oh, I've got the brought some herbs down as well. Oh, there's more to come. There's some in these ones down on here. There's some chives and stuff to come as well. Let me turn you around. There we go, it's me. Need a shave. yeah, that's it for me for this week. Feeling a slightly better of mood at the moment. Hopefully it will stay if I can remain avoiding people, if you know what I mean. I'll try to get this up very soon. As always, please subscribe if you haven't, like the video, click notify, and do talk to me below in the comments, because all of that helps me as a content maker. Not only does it encourage me, but also helps all of the magic at YouTube promote me to other people. Just over 300 subscribers at the moment. I would love to get over 1,000 so I can start monetizing. Yay! Income. Anyway, thank you very much indeed, and I'll see you again soon. Bye.